Hello and God bless everyone. Hi everybody, this is Spider, the CEO and founder of the Native American National Team. I want to welcome you to this video note, and I'm coming to you live from Mandawi City in the province of Cebu in the nation of the Philippines in Southeast Asia. The current date is Sunday the 6th. It is currently 3:05 p.m. here in the afternoon. In the west, in New York City, it is currently 2:05 a.m. And in the west, in California, Santa Cruz, California, where I'm from, it is 11:05 p.m. on Saturday evening the 5th. Wherever you might be in the world, whatever country or continent you are, we welcome you. And again, we say God bless you. We hope things are going well for you. Just wanted to share a few thoughts with you about what's happening with our national team, a little history, some things that have been going on as of late, and just share those thoughts with you now. First and foremost, what I wanted to share with everyone is that myself, personally, I really, really do appreciate you as a person who supports the Native American National Team. When we say that we are a family here, it's not just rhetoric or a play on words. It is, in fact, truth. I feel that we are a body of believers, and the believers are that this team has to be successful in order for the Native American people to reach its pinnacle and its ability to fulfill its destiny as a people. And every single one of you, no matter what country you're from, no matter what your lifestyle, background, persuasions are, we love you and we appreciate you. And when we say we love you, we have an agape love for you, which means an unconditional love, a love that there's nothing you can do that is going to make us turn from you. And we always ask you simply to come as you are, but come with the greatest amounts of optimism, good faith, and encouragement for your fellow family members here on the Native American National Team, a global family. I want to give you a quick history for those who do not understand or know. I founded this team back in 1997 after about a 12-year professional career, which included a short 2 months in the NBA in 1984 in the preseason with the Los Angeles Clippers. I was a starter at center at that time. After that year, a year later, I went to Europe for the first time and played in FIBA. Eventually ended up my career in 92 through 96 on the island of Cyprus, Division I FIBA, where I was a European champion and participated in the European Cup First Division. I was also blessed to be the sixth leading scorer in the world in 1992. And before I left, midway through the season, in my final season of 1996, I was a leading scorer in the world, approximately 35.8 points per game. It was shortly thereafter that when I came back, that the vision that the Creator gave to me for our people, and specifically for our athletes, both men and women, was to form an international program that our athletes could step into and mature into after college, so that they could go on and take advantage of their God-given abilities and follow their hopes and dreams to be a professional athlete, in this case a basketball player, and to live out the life of victory that God intends for every single one of us to live, regardless of what our hopes and dreams are. So it was with that idea that I started forming the team, of course, with my background playing at the NBA level and playing as a full-time professional. And in basketball, if you don't know, it's a very insecure industry, professional sports. People are replaced all the time. People have very short and brief careers due to the fact that there's overwhelming competition and that there's new and young talent coming in all the time, or people coming back from devastating injuries to go on and play fantastic, which means somebody else eventually is going to lose their job. So it's tremendously competitive. And as a result, Native Americans were really never given, we were never given our due overseas like in FIBA, in Division I, Division II. So I felt if we had an international program where we could showcase our talent, just like any other national team, coaches would see those players, contact us, ask them if they could sign them to contracts. Of course, we would represent them legally in contractual negotiations, having that background and professional expertise, and therefore bless the individual and allow them to go on and again live out their hopes and dreams, and to make us all proud as a Native American nation and people. So that was the goal. Now, economically, I want to share with you that I personally took out a loan, a personal loan, from an individual way back in 1999-2000. I signed documents for it, and I was responsible for paying that loan back. No one has really ever contributed except for one individual in Santa Cruz who contributed $1,000. Her name escapes me at the moment, please forgive me. And my elder from the Oglala Sioux tribe, Clinton Pilcher. Nobody had ever really contributed financially. We've had some people who just helped us contribute, about nine individuals, almost just a little under $100 to help us get a new computer, and we thank them publicly for their support. They blessed us. But it's an overwhelming expensive proposition just to take, you know, 15 to 17 individuals comprised of 12 players, a few coaches, a few administrators, to any destination, flying everybody in from places, putting them in hotels, paying them a per diem, which we did at the time of about $300 each. So just even players wise right there, as you can see, that gets close to about $4,500 to $5,000 just to give 15 to 17 people $300 each for 2 to 3 days to eat and pay their eating bills and whatnot on. So it's a very expensive proposition, and I have never had any desire or wish to put out anything but a first-rate international program. Remember, we are representing our nation and our people, and we're not going to pile into a van and, you know, drive 20-something hours in dangerous, icy conditions and so forth. We are going to do it, as I have experienced it, not only in the NBA, but at the NCAA Division I level, and as well as the Division I level FIBA and European Cup during my career. I want Native Americans to experience that life of victory that their talent affords them and that they should be blessed to experience. So to put a team together and just finance it for 6 months and have 12 players on average making, now listen to this, only $4,000 per person on average. You know, that budget is over $1 million when you put into insurances, traveling, per diems, of course, salaries for a few coaches, trainers, administrators. So it is a terribly expensive proposition no matter how you slice it. And we have never had any help in any regard from anyone. When we were going to have our first tryouts up at the Crow Tribe, they promised us help. And there was a judge at the time who got that word and extended that to us. So we scheduled a tryout there. And then literally the day before, the tribal chairman contacts the judge, and Judge Albert, and he says to him, sorry, but we don't have anything, and we're not going to be able to do anything for you. Now, this is less than 24 hours, and we were waiting to buy our tickets and so forth. So, you know, it's been a tough challenge, and other individuals have not stepped forward. Casinos have not stepped forward. Tribes have not stepped forward. And for whatever their reason is, you know, we're not worried about it. We're not concerned about it. We're not bad-mouthing anybody. It just simply is what it is. So what I've done, I have spent the last couple, 3 years of my life developing very large software models, including the biggest one, an eBay for the Native American community to sell their beautiful handcrafted arts and wares to the global community. To give you an idea how expensive that is, we contracted with a company out of Houston to finish the last 30%, and right now we're at 90% finished. We only need about 30 days more development and we will be finished. But at that point, the 30% that we contracted that they did the work for, we were paying one programmer, which is a typical going rate of about $60 an hour for this company. And if that programmer worked 40 hours a week, and if you do the math, that's $2,400 a week. So we're clocking almost $10,000 a month, $9,600 a month. Since there's usually a couple extra days, it does reach right about to the $10,000 mark. So as you can see, software development, if you're doing it right and you have proper individuals, unless you're blessed to get a freelancer program who's really good and will obviously contract you with you to do work at a, you know, $20 an hour rate, which is still expensive, you know, it's very expensive work. It's not kids play. It's something that you want to do your homework and be very careful when you're going to build something online so you make sure you get what you're paying for, because no matter who you pay, it is going to be expensive. These companies, this company and a few more, including iResBook.com, the social network I've been working on now, and again, that's about 90% finished. These are the companies that ultimately will sponsor the Native American national team and help us to procure that operating capital of at least $1 to $2 million annually, so it will finance all aspects of the operations of the teams, particularly obviously player salaries, insurances, first-rate health insurances, traveling accommodations per diem, uniforms, trainers, whatnot. But it's a staggering sum of money for a group of humble people, and particularly myself. So, but I have faith. I know that God is the author and the finisher of our faith, and He is the maker and keeper of our dreams. And He will help us finish what we started, and we will finish. We're simply looking for a few more investors who can help us with our Native American eBay, iResBook.com, our social network for the global Native American community. Once we get those started, particularly our eBay, that will make money from the get-go, and it'll be very successful. So we are looking for those. If you know of anybody who can help us and participate, even at the humble levels of a couple $1,000 as an investor to $5,000 to $10,000, we don't need a whole lot more than that actually to get started with our eBay. So please contact us if you know somebody. But I wanted you to give you a brief overview of our financial history. Now, that is going to lead to my next point here, talking about we've had some very unfortunate, misled, mean-spirited, derogatory individuals who have been, you know, saying a lot of slanderous, completely false and misleading things, not only about myself, but you know, many people within our global Native American national team family. And specifically, there's people like Dominique Vantel Lone Hunt, Lee Whitehorse out of Denver, Colorado, Roy Robertson out of Pennsylvania, a woman, Miss Lachey Young. These are individuals, and Dominique, let me go back to Dominique Vantel, who gave himself the self-anointed name of Lone Hunt. He is not American. Of course, he's not Native American. He is a black, either Caribbean or Jamaican national. It is my opinion that he has got NCNN News, Native Citizen News Network, and he's simply trying to make money off our community. I did my homework and due diligence in investigating him online, and there's some issues there that another individual, Rob Schmidt, a blogger from the blogosphere, had pointed out about him, a white individual who doesn't obviously appear to have any reason to pick a fight with him or anybody for that reason, but he felt he was doing things specifically to take advantage of our community. That was his opinion. You can judge for yourself. You can read it online. And it's on our post here on Facebook and our page. Just scroll down, you'll see it. But these are individuals who've attacked us. An example, Dominique Vantel Lone Hunt. Let me help you to understand. When we were going to get the new computer, I asked for some help within the Native American community, donations, whatnot. And he started attacking me, and he went so far as to say not only was I not Native American, that I was not even American, and that I was from Yugoslavia or somewhere in Europe, etc. Now, these are outright, obviously, lies, and they're designed to deceive people and to build up resentment and anger against individuals. And to some degree, I think he was successful based on what I have seen on Facebook and whatnot. Now, that being said, I'm not concerned about it because, as Thomas Paine said, and I will repeat this for anybody who struggles with what other people say about you, he said that reputation is what men and women think of us, but character is what God and the angels know of us. Hallelujah. So don't worry about your reputation. Just know who you are in the Creator, who you are in Allah, who you are in Christ Jesus like Spider. You don't have to worry about those other people. They can't do anything to change your destiny. Your destiny is squarely in your hands like the Native American.